Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Drake Caterpillar. This ship has a lot of problems with our current shield tech. Because of her stretched shape, she takes a lot of damage even when shields are still way up, and quite a few parts of this ship are not even covered by the shields. And we are starting with 1+1 missile. Shields front side 97, stern at maximum. 1+2 missile. Shields front side 95, stern at maximum. 1+3 missile. Shields front side 94, stern at maximum. 1+5 torpedo. Shields front side 88, stern at maximum. 2+5 torpedoes. Shields front side 76, stern at maximum, and this time no orange spot at the front. That's interesting, but I wouldn't think too much about this. And we have another ship with immersive reflections. And look where the light source is. It's above and a little bit behind us. So this should never give such reflections. I hate this crap, to be honest. This isn't immersive, Chris. This is just a waste of time on your side with something no one can ever use or find immersive. The bigger torpedoes now, 1+9 torpedo. Shields front side 12, stern at maximum, and we have a tiny... No, we don't have a red spot at the front. That's really strange. No red spot at the front. Did CHG did something? The Caterpillar always took a lot of damage, even when shields were still way up. But I wouldn't think too much about this. This might just be a coincidence. 2+9 torpedoes. The two memes explain why I do this, and I use missiles and torpedoes as my yardsticks. Caterpillar is done in 3.7 before I start. When you look at my data, it seems like Saber sucks and Titan and Auroram are looking good. However, Titan and Auroram are using bulwarks. Those shields give a lot of shield HPs, but they have a very low regen rate, while the Saber is using stealth shields with a very high regen rate and with no regen delay damaged. But if you want to, you can make the Saber very tough against high alpha damage. Saber can have easily more than 21,000 shield HPs. Might not be your best choice, though. So I made some videos. Links to my videos are in the top right corner, so you can decide which loadout you want to use. So Caterpillar in 3.7, she is about on the same level toughness-wise as the Origin 600i and tougher than the Warden. Let's take a look at the comparison. I've data of the Caterpillar from 2.6.3 to today, and between 3.6 and 3.7 nothing changed in regards to shields, missile, torpedo or gun damage. So those numbers should be identical, and they are, but there's one strange thing. The Caterpillar always took damage even with shields way up. Front red, front red, front red, front red, but this time I couldn't get the front red with two size 5 torpedoes, and I couldn't get the front red with one size 9 torpedo, and even when shields were very strong and torpedoes very weak, one size 9 torpedo aimed at the front shields 83% front side stern max and front red. This seems to be gone, and I did it a few more times off camera. Now, we all know that the shield rework is moved from 3.6 to 4.0 for now. But maybe ZIG fixed the shields of the Caterpillar a little bit, I am not sure. Maybe this is just coincidence. Who knows? Would I go into battle in a Caterpillar in 3.7? Let's rephrase this. Would I use a Caterpillar? Yes! Well, the Caterpillar has a few problems. You still cannot undock the command module, and her stretched shape and the current shield tech just don't match. But no one can deny the fact that we can transport a lot of cargo in a Caterpillar. So you can still make a lot of money with a Caterpillar in 3.7. My rating for the Caterpillar in 3.7 is a 5 out of 10, which is not a bad rating for me. For me, 5 out of 10 is average, and when CHG is fixing the problems, this rating will go up, no doubt about it. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet, to my locus data, and a lot more guides in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video, and see you next time. Bye. Auf Wiedersehen. Oh shit, no power.
What can I do for you, Captain? Do you know how to install a power regulator?
Sure, I know.
Step 1. Pick up your power regulator. Step 2. Approach the terminal located in our engine room. Step 3. Insert power regulator. Step 4. Celebrate.
Shit! Hey, you are still here. You might want to join me on Twitter. My Twitter account is Kameral_FFM, and this is the city I live in, Frankfurt am Main. On Twitter I post about my videos and sometimes just some funny little videos.
Action!
Would be nice if you would join me on Twitter.